Hi, everybody. Happy holidays. This is Laura Williams coming at you from Dearborn, Michigan. I am representing My Wine Witch and mywinewitch.com, which is a personal endeavor that I started just a few months ago. Being a full-time mom and selling wine throughout my life over the past approximately 20 years in one aspect or another, I have realized that there was a need in the industry for a more creative, versatile, accessible vehicle for which we could introduce wine and make it much more interesting and a little less scary for the everyday consumer. So that is where My Wine Witch was born. Some of you may recognize me from being out in the market with Alpina Beverage Company and Vintage Wine Company and also Woodbury Wine. Being a wine sales manager and working with wine distributors as a sales rep has enabled me to become very familiar with wine. As many of you know, wine is my passion. I find it very interesting and creative, and it's something that I just kind of fell into over the past 10 years or so. So that is bringing me to where we are today. Jodine Compton from the Alpina Association of Lifelong Learners contacted me just a few months ago and said, hey, Laura, would you be interested in doing a YouTube segment for our group? We're always looking for new content, something interesting, maybe holiday themed. So she and I put our heads together and spent some time figuring out subject and content matter, and we came up with the Mulled Wine Workshop that we are about to do here in just a little bit. I do want to thank Jodine Compton as well as the Alpina Association for Lifelong Learners for letting me be a part of this. This is my very first YouTube, so I'm a little nervous, which I don't usually get nervous, but this platform and format is a little bit different for me. I had to do some cleaning here at my house and make things look nice and YouTube ready for you all. So hopefully the dogs behave in the background and things can be nice and quiet so I can explain to you a little bit about what is mulled wine. So here we go. I would like to introduce to you the Glunz family winery and cellars. Glunz, G-L-U-N-Z. And this may be found at www.glunzfamilywinery.com. So I had to do a lot of studying and research to roll out this YouTube video, and I learned a lot. It was very interesting. Prior to my preparation for this video, I did I was aware of Glogg and mulled wine, sangria, of course, but this definitely took it to a new level as far as what the fine differences are with those. So referencing the Glunz family winery and cellars, it started back in 1871 when Louis Glunz, age 17, left Germany in pursuit of the American dream. So I think that's a really interesting start to this workshop. They moved to Chicago in 1872, and the American dream was realized in 1888 when he was able to set up shop as a wine, beer, and spirit merchant on Wells and Division Street in Chicago. His entire family ended up being in this industry. In 1992, the third generation of the Glunz family opened their winery, specializing in small batch fortified wines, which kind of brings us to where we are today, because essentially the Glunz that we are learning about today is a fortified wine. Today, the Glunz family winery is located in 40 acres of rolling hills in Paso Robles, California. So they still do have shop in Chicago, but of course their winery is located in California. So this brings us to our wine. And as you can tell, it is very festive today. I've got it all blinged up. It is, you know, 'tis the season for the winter and holiday weather. So our bottle has its little scarf on and its little hat. These are available on Amazon. The young lady that was crocheting some for me, who is a local gal, unfortunately, was struggling with COVID. So I had to order these on Amazon. Try to shop local whenever possible. But this is the bottle, and I have decorated it with something that I make. This is a cork ornament, so this is just a little decorative aspect that you can add, and those are available on my website and also on my Etsy page too. So this is the bottle for the Vin Glogg. made by the Glunz family. And as you can tell, it's a beautiful bottle. The label is very decorative, very seasonal, very memorable. It is a wonderful package for a retail setting, for example. Any of your local privately owned and even your big box chain stores should have this. They should have it now in their shelves and available on the floor for you to purchase. So this is what it looks like. And if you forget what it looks like, you can again look on the Glunz Family Winery website to look up the label. But please take note that this is a 1 liter bottle. So this is not a normal bottle, which is going to be the volume of 750 milliliter. This is going to be a little bit bigger. So this has got a little more juice in it. So it's got more bang for your buck. It is available on their website at $12.99, I think it said. So if you're having a hard time finding it locally and you can't find it for your local retailer or restaurant owner, you can go to the Glunz Family website and you can order it and they will deliver it to your home. So it's a 1 liter bottle. And little bit of information from the side of the label. This is a blend of California port and red wine. So we talked for a moment just a little while ago about it being a fortified wine. It's not just a red wine, it also has port wine in it. So that is one of the things that makes it a Glogg wine. It also has natural fruit flavors and spices. So this is what the bottle looks like. And again, it's a 1 liter volume, so it's definitely a bigger size bottle and great for entertaining. The other thing I want you to take note of is the really nice top of the bottle. So this is not just your normal bottle. This is something that can be recycled. It has the glass embossed logo of the Glunz Family Cellars and Vineyards logo impression on the bottle. And this bottle can and should be reused. I have many customers in the restaurant and bar industry that use this after the juice and the inside of the bottle is gone to serve water tableside for their guests. They take the label off, they put water inside, and they put a pretty flower on the inside of the bottle. So it is definitely to be recycled and should be, because it's a beautiful bottle. So this is what the bottle looks like. And again, it does not come with this, but if you're interested in gifting it with a cork, please visit my Etsy site or my website. So this is what the bottle looks like. Doing a little research on the Vin Glogg. Did you know Glogg is a holiday favorite in many Scandinavian cultures? It is commonly served on St. Lucia Day, which is very close to my birthday. So December 13th is St. Lucia's Day. My birthday is the 17th, just saying. Right around Christmas time. Not surprisingly, the word Glogg, which is written as Glogg, is of Scandinavian origin. It means to burn or to mull. So one of the things that you need to know, the main differences between Glogg and mulled wine, is because Glogg has got lots of juicy tidbits in it. The Scandinavian people really like to put slivered almonds, raisins, dried cranberries, oranges in it, and it should be enjoyed in a mug with a handle with a spoon. So you can enjoy those little tidbits and fruits and nuts that are infused at the bottom of the mug. So that is kind of the difference between a Glogg, which has the nuts and the fruits in it, which are infused by the alcohol, and a mulled wine, which normally doesn't have all those additional things in it. Now, both of them are gonna be fortified. They'll either have a port wine in it. For example, this Vin Glogg already comes with the port wine in it and the spices in it. This is ready to serve. This is one of the reasons why I wanted to feature this wine for this workshop, because essentially you open it, you can warm it on the stovetop or warm it in a crock pot, and it's ready to go. Get your mug, garnish it with a little cinnamon stick, an orange slice, and it's ready to go. Whereas if you want to make your own, that's where you're gonna have to look at the internet. So I am gonna have a few recipes and a few links that are going to be available on this YouTube video that will show other opportunities if you can't get your hands on the Vin Glogg. Some other really interesting information is that the Glogg, you need to be saying Glogg and not Glogg. So make sure that you know that. Glogg and not Glogg. Got a little history lesson for you here. I'm an art major. History isn't really my thing, but I find it very interesting, especially when it comes to wine. So looking at the interwebs, the oldest Glühwein, which means glowing wine in German, which I'm a little bit German thanks to my dad. The oldest Glühwein in Germany is dated back to the year 1420. Can you believe that? It's really old. So Glühwein is red wine with some cinnamon and sugar and orange. So Glühwein, which means glowing wine, is going to be very similar to the Glögg, whereas the Glögg is originated in Scandinavia, and Germany is the origination of Glühwein. So we're going to talk a little bit about Glühwein. And again, I'm just a little bit German. I do not speak German. So it dated back to 1420. And, you know, history says that the Romans invented mulled wine to save extra wine. So in an effort to save some of the wine that may have been turning, they doctored it up. So they doctored it up by adding sugar to it, some spices, some alcohol, to kind of mask some of that aging old wine flavor that they were getting from some of the wine that was turning in not a good way. So essentially, that's what Glühwein, the glowing wine, is. They doctored it up, they added sugar, a little bit of alcohol, some spices, they warmed it. So that essentially masked some of that older wine flavor. They used it, they really stretched it out. They weren't about to just throw it out. You own your own bar or restaurant and you're looking to save some of that wine that maybe you've opened for by the glass pours, got a bunch of wine that's open, you need to be making some mulled wine or some Glühwein from it. Doctor it up. Tons of different recipes. This one that I'm looking at right now, History of Glühwein. They've got traditional Glühwein, and this is available at german-glühwein.com, and that is spelled G-L-U-H-W-E-I-N.com. In a moment, we're going to talk about some of the spices that go into Glühwein or Glögg. There are a lot of different spices, and at Rusty Petunias in Alpena, Michigan, one of my favorite little spots, my friends over there have got a package that is made with a bunch of the different delicious spices that go into the Glögg. So that's going to include things like cardamom, cinnamon, star anise, some yummy things like that. Stay tuned. We're gonna go over to the stove and start making some. I wish that you were here so you could smell it because it smells so beautiful. It's one of the most wonderful things to have when you're entertained. Okay, I'm back. Vin Glögg should be served warm. In a cup, and then enjoy. Make sure if you're putting those yummy tidbits in there, like the raisins and cranberries and almonds and walnuts that I had talked about, that you serve it with a spoon for your guests. You're gonna blow their minds when they come over and you're entertaining. Your guests are gonna walk in. Your decorations are so beautiful. Thanks for having us. And what is that beautiful aroma? Oh, that's nothing. Just a drink I've got prepared on the stove for you. And they're so impressed when they see the Vin Glögg and you're serving it to them in a beautiful mug with the garnish, and it smells wonderful and it tastes wonderful. It really is the essence of the holidays. All right, everybody, we're back and we are at the stovetop. And as you'll notice, I'm gonna do this here at the stovetop, but you can also do it in a crock pot if you'd like. The one thing that's super important, you cannot let it boil, because if you let your wine boil, it will actually boil off the alcohol. And we don't want that, of course. We wanna be able to enjoy the wonderful spirits that is in the Vin Glögg and the mulled wine, if that's the way that you are choosing to go. You'll notice that I've got my spices here. So I've got some whole clove, which, beautiful aroma. I wish you could smell it, but it just reminds me of Christmas being little. My mom and dad would have us make the orange crafts where you would insert the whole clove into the orange, and we would have them as centerpieces at Christmas, and that's just a really nice memory of mine. And then, of course, some fresh orange slices, beautiful citrus aroma. I've got some walnuts here that I'm going to be adding as well. And then I have some dried cranberries too. So this is what I'm going to be adding to my stovetop yumminess here. So the Vin Glögg, and I've opened it, of course. We talked about the beautiful bottle and how nice it is. So we're just gonna go ahead and we're gonna add this. And I am entertaining tonight, so I'm gonna be adding this whole giant entire bottle, because I know from
experiences in the past that people really, really enjoy this. And once they have a glass, they usually want a few more. So again, I'm gonna warm this up and I'm going to add my oranges. So this is one bottle and I'm adding half of an orange to this, the slices. Then I'm going to be adding the walnuts. This is about a quarter of a cup of walnuts and about a quarter of a cup of these dried cranberries or dried cherries. You can also use raisins, golden raisins if you'd like, or dark raisins. And then I'm gonna add the cloves as well, okay? So we're gonna add that. We're gonna let that yumminess just mull there on the stovetop. You can see it, it's beautiful, and we're gonna let it do its thing. Starting to simmer, and we're just gonna come back in about 5 minutes and check on it. Stir it, okay? So our Vin Glogg has been on the stove for just about 5 minutes. As you can still tell, it's starting to steam. I just wanted to make sure that everybody saw how beautiful these oranges are. Such a pretty color. One of the things that I enjoy most about the Vin Glogg or the mulled wine experience is just seeing the appearance of the wine in the glass. Through a transparent glass, you can see how pretty it is. Just the dark, deep violet hues of the wine. Of course, it's fortified with port, so it's got that really gorgeous appearance. And then the oranges are picking that up as well. I also wanted to make sure that everybody knows that they can strain their goodies. So if your guests have already had a glass or two of this, you don't want them biting into a whole clove. So at that point, if you wanted to strain this batch, or maybe not even add cloves, as far as just adding oranges, cinnamon sticks, things like that, you wouldn't have to strain it, because nobody wants to bite into a whole clove, of course. But it is still steaming up here. I'm gonna give it just a few more minutes and then we'll come back. I'll show you how to strain it and how to serve it and enjoy it, the best part, right? Okay, so at this point, it's starting to get hot. We don't want it to boil because we know what happens then. We lose the alcohol. So I'm gonna try to do this without making a mess. So we're gonna strain this, which means that the infused goodies, like the nuts and the oranges, won't be in the glass. Just because I did decide to add those cloves. We don't want anybody biting into a whole clove, right? So there it is, it's very beautiful. It's been strained. We're gonna pour it into a glass mug with a handle, of course. You wouldn't wanna serve this in a regular wine glass because the glass would be too hot. And I've got this garnished with a spoon in case you need it. But again, it's not necessary because it doesn't have the fruits and nuts, but I do have a fresh orange. So that is what it looks like. Follow me to the table where I will enjoy a glass with you.
So here we are for the best part. Here is the Vin Glogg. It has been warmed on the stovetop. Beautiful aroma. Aromas of cherries, dark red stone fruits like plums, cranberries, a little nutty. You get some of that walnut, almond accent to it. It's very warm and cozy. You can tell it's got a high ABV, most definitely. It's got a kick in the pants here. Cheers and happy holidays to you. Very warm, warms you from the inside out. Definitely get that cinnamon and nutmeg flavor profile to it, along with the red stone fruits. It's really nice because it's a great entertaining beverage. There are a lot of different types of people that would enjoy something like this because it's a little on the off dry side. Isn't very sweet, but is very flavorful. Cheers. Happy holidays. Enjoy responsibly. All right, ladies and gentlemen, the last thing that I want to talk to you about today in this YouTube video is the before and after of the bottle. We are really big into recycling and reusing and reducing here at My Wine Witch, and we do that with reusing corks for decorative purposes, ornaments, bling, keychains, things like that, and that's on my Etsy page and mywinewitch.com. But most importantly, and one of my, most expressive creative outlets is by reusing wine bottles. So this is the empty bottle of the Vin Glogg. So this is before, again, beautiful bottle. And this is one of the versions that I've done with an empty bottle. So I've used this kind of as an apothecary jar, a winter wonderland scene. What I do is I take the bottles and I soak them in boiling water. I scrape off the labels. I use Goo Gone and a Mr. Clean eraser, and I make sure that all the residue from the labels are gone. Then I wash it with soap and water. It's a little labor intensive, but it is definitely worth it. And once it's clean, then I let my creative juices flow. This is one of the themes that I've used for this bottle in particular. It's got marbles on the bottom, some fake snow, some greenery, some berries, as well as snowflakes. I've also done bottles using the Vin Glogg bottle with the decorative lights on the inside. So it's just really what your heart is calling for as far as a creative outlet for the bottles. So don't throw these bottles away. Hold on to them. Reuse them. If you have some at home and don't know what to do with them, please contact me on mywinewitch.com. I also wanted to make sure that everybody knew that my website is brand new. It is still under construction, so please be patient with me. We appreciate your support, supporting female small-owned businesses. I also want to give a shout-out to Jodine Compton and the Alpena Community College Association for Lifelong Learners. Got a lot of friends in that group, and I miss you all at the Black Sheep Wine Club. I hope that everybody up north is doing well. And I also wanted to thank my friends at Rusty Petunias. I miss you girls, and I hope you're doing well, and I hope that this event brings in a lot of business for you on Wednesday. Happy holidays. Merry Christmas. Be responsible. Cheers, witches.